what I mean. Is it true that you decided? Obviously not.
Well, that's right, but I wondered what, who might be leaking what to him, why he would be saying that I had decided.
Oh, hell, he's just talking that way, Mr. President. He doesn't need any leak to say a thing like that. The truth isn't in it. It's tomorrow morning I'm worried about when he and Ford get together. And what's their press conference scheduled for 11 o'clock or something like that?
Yes, I told Joe to call you this morning as soon as I saw it scheduled. You know what it's going to be about?
No, I don't, but I think it may be on this Twining article and Twining book and Vietnam in conjunction with that.
What does Twining say besides he's against you on PFA?
Well, he says that we're not pursuing a manned bomber the way we should, and that we just don't have enough military power. He's got a record of having refused to support airlift and mobility, which is really the foundation of our power in Vietnam today. We're digging out quotes on that, so if Laird or Ford makes these points tomorrow, we'll be able to rebut them. As far as this other point that you've made a decision after the election to substantially build up the forces, if Ford makes that tomorrow, I think I can just say it's absolutely untrue.
What are we doing? Giving Westmoreland what he wants, what he's asking for, is about $15,000 a month?
Yeah, it's a little higher now. It's around 20, and in some months it may be 25.
How many are coming home?
This is net increase. The number that will be brought back by the end of December is 285,000 men. But despite that 285,000 being brought back, there's a net increase each month of between roughly 15 and 25,000. We have about 310,000 men there today, approximately. By the end of the year, that'll be awfully close to 400,000. Westmoreland has asked for additional numbers to be introduced next year, which by the end of next year would bring the total up to between 550 and 600,000. What I think has happened is that Ford or Laird has got some smell of the increases that will take place in the future, the continuing increase, and feel they're safe in making that statement as a result. They've just watched the statistics, and each month they've seen this 15 to 20,000 increase, so they know that by the end of the year we'll have about 60 to 80,000 more than we have today, and if we've got 310 today, we're damn certain to have 400 by the end of the year. And they know that that's probably going to go on next year.
I guess the best thing is just to pay no attention to it.
Well, I think it depends on how much play it gets. It hasn't gotten much play so far. I've been watching. He's been saying this, Mr. President, for several weeks. And I've watched his statements in the press, and up at least through noon today, he hasn't gotten much publicity on it. I am fearful about tomorrow, and we'll have to watch that very carefully.
Now, if they get me these appropriation bills, you may have to get on out to Vietnam pretty quick to see what you're going to have.
Because
it's conceivable we might have to come back to them right quick and say, okay, if you really want to pass a bill, here's what we're going to have.
If
you get the best figures available you can without letting them get out.
Right. I'll be prepared to do that, Mr. President, and I could go to Vietnam very promptly. And I've had my budget people working on it. I would hope we didn't have to bring a supplement up immediately, but if we did, we could move very, very quickly.
Well, we might not have a supplement. We might just give them the estimate and ask for the tax bill.
All right, we could do that.
We had to. I just want to be prepared.
Sure. I'll be prepared, Mr. President. I'm gradually getting, as we get closer and closer to the end of the calendar year, I'm getting closer and closer to a reasonable estimate of a supplement. I got one just the other day, as a matter of fact, and I'll give you the figures for whatever they're worth, and recognizing they're only tentative, but the new obligation authority request would be for about $11 billion, and the expenditure effect above the $58.6 billion, which was in your budget, would be about $7.5 billion to a total of 58.6 plus 7.5 or 66 billion. That's the best figure I have at the moment. And I don't want to stand on that, but if you had to give a figure in mid-October or early October, we could refine that and support it. What I'm much more concerned about, Mr. President, is what we should be doing on the bombing and the force levels and our whole position out there. And when you have time, I want to talk to you further about it. I myself am more and more convinced that we ought definitely to plan on termination of the bombing in the north, but not until after the election. And I hate to even talk about it before then, for fear to leak.
God will.
So I haven't said anything in this building yet, but I just wanted to exchange some views with you when you have time on it. And I think also that we ought to be planning, as I mentioned before, on a ceiling on our force levels. I don't think we ought to just look ahead to the future and say we're going to go higher and higher and higher and higher, 600,000, 700,000, whatever it takes. I think we'll break the economy of that country, and substitute U.S. soldiers for South Vietnamese, and will distort the whole pattern of conduct in South Vietnam that we do. And we ought now to be planning on the ceiling of our forces. And I would think they ought to be somewhere between 500 and 600,000 ought to be the ceiling. And after the election, we ought to tell that to our military commanders and get them planning on it.
Right. Now, Bob, on the economic thing, we have been rolled back to deposits of 5% on CDs, 5.5%, and that will let the savings and loans stay 5.25%,
yeah.
And that'll help us come there. We're going to get a good supervision bill where we can give them much closer supervision. We had hearings on that today. Our tax bill is making some progress, but the two things I think you could really concentrate on, you'd get the best promoter you ever heard of to get as much money in from Vietnam on your 10% savings as you can, and get your contractors to everybody that has an order from any of your services, see that all their employees really realize that they ought to be buying bonds. That would help us a little. We're cutting down on all of our securities. We're not selling anything for new money, but we do need to take a little of this cream off the top, and we're really not doing it as a government. We did it with the agencies, and we got $500 million, but we're not really doing it on the industrial front and on the military front. It would help our balance payments too. So if they could do two things: one, concentrate on the bond front, and two, just tell your damn procurement officers don't buy anything you don't have to buy from Vietnam from now till November. I think that'll get around pretty soon, that the economy is not as robust as it is. You send a big order for plywood or lump something in there, why, it shoots up. But with all of us holding back a little bit, as we did in June, it sure does show, and with our cutting the $3 or $4 billion we're going to cut, maybe we can temper this a little bit. So take those two things, and I'll talk to you about them maybe Saturday or maybe tomorrow if you know anything on it, but probably later in the week.
All right, sir.
Thank you, Bob.